To find the antiderivative of the cubed cotangent divided by the cosecant, first what you want to do, you want to rewrite the numerator as basically the first thing is to split the cotangent cubed as cotangent squared, let it be the new numerator divided by the cosecant x, and then multiply by the remainder of the original factor, which is cotangent x dx. So now what you want to do, you want to express the cotangent squared in terms of the cosecant squared minus 1. Okay, so we're going to have cosecant squared x minus 1 divided by the cosecant x multiplied by the cotangent x dx. So why am I doing this? I'm doing this so that I get rid of this troublesome cotangent squared, because there's nothing we can do with it. If we let everything be in terms of the cosecant other than this part here, then it will be easy to use the substitution. You will see how this works, right? So let's see. So now the first integral, simplified version of it, will be cosecant squared divided by the cosecant gives you the net factor cosecant, right? Multiplied to the cotangent. Now this one is easy to recognize. The antiderivative is going to be minus cosecant x, right? Plus an arbitrary constant, right? So this part is easy. The second integral minus cotangent x divided by cosecant x dx. Okay, so this is minus cosecant x plus an arbitrary constant k. I'm not going to put a c yet because we have to solve for the second antiderivative. Now you might be stuck here, but here's an idea. We can express this product as cotangent x multiplied by the 1 over cosecant x dx. Okay, so let's keep going. So we can write the cotangent as the cosine of x divided by the sine of x. And then we know that the 1 over cosecant is exactly sine, right? So we get sine x being multiplied. So as a result, look what happens. The sine x's get canceled out because the sine x multiplies the numerator at this part. Right? So we happen to have a very easy way out here. And not like we expected originally, right? So as a result, this is negative cosecant x, and then we just have a cosine, right? Because these are gone, cosine x dx, the antiderivative of the cosine is the sine, right? So minus sine x, and I'm not going to write the arbitrary k because now we have another arbitrary constant that together with the first constant will give you plus c, the final constant. Right, so this is the correct antiderivative. If you got this answer, it means you did the correct work. Congratulations. Thanks for watching this video. I hope this was a lot of fun. See you in the next one.